Around the World with MS World, I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor, President of the Florida Society of Neurology. One of the great things about being at a meeting like the 23rd meeting of the European Neurological Society is to see how different medications may have similar results in terms of certain aspects. In this case, we're looking at safety. Earlier on, we spoke to Dr. Chris Legank about a medication called fingolimod or gilenia and its risk of infection and how we could not connect it to the lymphocyte or the white blood cell counts. Similarly here with a medication that's in development and currently being looked at by the regulators called IV Alemtuzumab, probably will have the brand name Lymtrada, used to have the brand name Campath when it was being used for cancer. And what they found is while the medication did increase the risk of infection the month after the first dosing of the medication, the second course of treatment, the whole year later, did not seem to increase it. And you couldn't match the lymphocyte counts, so the actual lab test, to people who are at risk of infection or not. This brings up once again that while it's important to do your laboratory safety monitoring, it's not always clear how that lab monitoring can tell us who is and who isn't at risk for infections. So please, keep your doctor informed, and please, if you're having any side effects from any of the medicines, let your doctor know immediately. Thank you for joining us.